Hello, students. Today we're going to do one story from the book called Keep Reading. Keep Reading, it's a story, so we're not going to do anything from English time books today. The story is vocabulary for the story is behind me. The story is called The Brave Knight. Is it knight or prince? Let me take a look.
Knight.
Where's the brave knight?
勇敢故事呢，老师要讲的是一个勇敢的骑士。没错，the
brave knight. The brave knight, he's fighting with a dragon, actually, to save the princess.
哦，他故事呢是那个骑士呢，要跟一个恐龙对抗。Dragon
是恐龙吗？不是恐龙，他跟龙，说成恐龙，龙
dragon 是龙，要跟龙对抗，然后去救公主。没错，now
let's take a look at vocabulary first. Vocabulary is right here. The words are a little small, that's the best we can do.
好，老师说。来，我们来看单词就对了。看一看我们有什么东西。
I will say in English. The teacher will explain a little how to use that word.
我大概讲一下怎么使用。第一个叫这样子
，get tired of
有很多目。
Get tired of
Get tired of 这里你前面就用一个主词，好看你的文法。所以我的话，然后我就用 I get tired of。 那如果你后面接名词，那就用名词。假设我今天常常吃披萨，那我可以说 I get tired of pizza，那就是我对这个披萨已经感到厌倦、厌烦，就很烦了，不想吃了。这样用吧。
get tired of。Get tired of， 如果已经发生这个事情 ，GET 要不要变 GOT 过去的用法？所以我们就说这样子 ，I got tired of talking to him。
好，那这个例句是接动词，那同学记得要动词要接 ing。没错。对，所以他的意思说，哦，我意思跟他说话 ，talk to him 啊，是跟他讲话，意思说我已经跟他讲话已经感到厌倦、厌烦了，所以已经不想跟他说话，所以用 I got tired of。
没错，I got tired of talking to him， 所以呢，我们是 I got tired of， 如果后面是一个动作是 ving， 所以 I got tired of listening to the same songs，I got tired of watching TV，I got tired of playing same online game all the time。第二个这叫 special，
哦，这个同学应该都听过，special，特别特殊的。
This is a special gift for you。
同学应该听得懂，这是一个特别的礼物要送你的。没错，这里面不能的部分。特别的。Eventually。 好，最后。好，同学要跟着老师念哦。Eventually
we finished our homework.
这里指你的动作是最后呢，我们完成了我们的功课。没错，
所以你要记得这个词很好用的。等一下我们看故事里面，当时怎么说？说 eventually，下一个词叫 defeat。
好，那个是 F 哈 ，B E F E A
T，B E F E A T 打败，过去他已经给你写 defeat 是这样子，过去的时候要多一个 E D 变这样子 defeated， 所以 this team was defeated by that team. For example， 如果你们喜欢看 NBA， 那就是 Game 3 Milwaukee Bucks won Suns， so Suns were defeated by Bucks in Game 3， 那是2-1。Rescue， attention， will they defeat their enemy？ 这个是看一下后面一个问号，它是从 will 开始，所以大家想未来的时候 ，Lin 老师会说清楚一点 ，Will they defeat their enemy？
他们将打败他们的敌人吗 ？Enemy 敌人？没错，不知道大家会有个什么东西？
War 嘛，maybe rescue
解救。The
hero rescued the villagers。
这个。 英雄解救了这里村庄的人。没错，所以更像，更像在这种叫做这样子
village，可以说村落、村庄。Village 就是名词的用法，住在那个地方我们叫做 villagers，villagers 就是 farmers， village villagers。 Hero 是谁？英雄。可以，swear。
发誓，我发誓。哎，那你看它的过去的用法变这样子
swore。 Swore 就是过去的用法。 He swore that his story was true.
他发誓呢，那个故事是真的啦。没错，他说的故事是真的。下一个就是
princess，
公主。
Her parents treat her like a princess.
好，这里的 treat 是款待对待，所以我的意思，他的父母亲对待他就像对待他像一位公主一样对待他。
没错，下一个就是 hurt，
动词伤害。
而且这个 hurt 的动词我看过特别多次，因为你们的 lesson 5 in hospital， 那个 about body parts，
哪边痛啊？
对啊 ，body part 的 hurt， your leg hurts， her ear hurts。
对，所以有疼痛或者是伤害的意思。
hurt 我看过很多次。
啊，你的 example 没有用。
Don't hurt the cat when you take it out of the cage。
好，所以例句是不要伤害它。当你把它伤害那个谁，猫咪哈。当你把它从笼子拿出来的时候，不要伤害它哦。
Yeah, so me, 不知道，that's maybe little cat, kitten 吧。So don't hurt the cat when you take it just a time out of the cage. And now we're gonna look at the story. Let's see story tonight over here. Yes. Can you share? This is the biggest we can make it. Actually, bigger than yesterday. Let's take a look. First time I just read the whole story, and student just listen.See how many things can you understand by yourself.
好，老师先念，看你能听懂多少英文。
And Teacher Lin will translate the story. Many years ago, there lived a dragon. The villagers were so afraid of the dragon that each week they had to give the dragon some presents. At first, they brought it some food. The dragon soon got tired of this and wanted more presents. Each week, the presents that the villagers gave became more and more special.One day, the dragon said with anger, I'm tired of your boring presents. To show my power, I want you to bring the princess here to me. They were frightened of the dragon, so they finally did what the dragon requested. The prince felt sorry for the princess, so he rode to the dragon's house on his own. They fought for 3 days. Eventually, the prince defeated the bad dragon. The dragon begged and swore he would never hurt the villagers again.The princess was rescued, and the villagers were not worried anymore. Now let's look at the story one more time. The book we're going to give to Teacher Lin, maybe she needs to take a look. And I say once, you say once. Very quickly. Many years ago, there lived a dragon.
很多年前呢，住着那很多年前那里住着一只龙。
The villagers were so afraid of the dragon that each week they had to give the dragon some presents.
那个村庄的人呢是很害怕那个龙，然后每个礼拜呢他们都必须给龙一些礼物。
At first they brought it some food.
首先呢他们一开始啊、哦、就这样，一开始他们是有带一些食物给他。
没错，这个 brought 是也是过去的动词，大部分如果你要看故事，很多的动词是过去的方式，因为是很久以前的事情。所以这个 brought 它的原始动词是 bring， 啊，那它的意思就是
携带带来的意思。
也是，对。At first they brought it some food， 你去翻译吗？
对。
The dragon soon got tired of this and wanted more presents。
这一只龙呢，很快呢，它就感到厌倦哈、哦，厌倦这种每次送来就是这样子的礼物。然后他就想要更多的礼物。
Each week, the presents that the villagers gave became more and more special.
每个礼拜呢，那个礼物呢就变成，因为村庄要给他礼物，所以就每个礼拜这个礼物就越来变得越来越特别了。
也好，他们特别需要比较好的东西。One day, the dragon said with anger.
有一天呢，那个龙呢讲话是带着语气，是非常生气的说
，I'm tired of your boring presents.
我对你们的带来的礼物已经感到厌倦厌烦了，很烦你们带来的这些礼物。
To show my power，
为了展现我的多么厉害哈。
I want you to bring the princess here to me，
我想要你们把公主带来这里给我。
They were frightened of the dragon， so they finally did what the dragon requested。
他们呢真的很害怕这只龙，所以呢他们终于还是。答应了那个龙、哦、所以他们就真的答应龙把那个公主要带来给他的。
没错，在这里的动词，如果是没有翻译很清楚 ，request 就是要求，
所以他们终于答应那个龙的要求。
没错 ，The prince felt sorry for the princess, so he rode to the dragon's house on his own.
这个王子呢 ，prince 王子那就对这位公主感到抱歉，所以呢，他就呢。把那个就是自己呢带着公主到龙的家。
去跟他讲话。He rode to the dragon's house on his own。
哦，还没带公
主，公主已经在那边了。
公主已经在那边了，他已经带过去了。哦，好，那就是他已经答应龙的要求了，所以王子就觉得很为这个公主感到抱歉，所以他就自己去龙的家。
对 ，They fought for 3 days。
哦，所以他们就打了3天的仗。
Eventually, the prince defeated the bad dragon.
最后呢，王子呢，打败了这一只坏的龙。
The dragon begged and swore never to hurt the villagers again.
龙呢，那个就祈求说，并且发誓说，他将不会再伤害这里的村庄的人了。
The princess was rescued.
公主被拯救了。
And the villagers were not worried anymore.
然后村庄的人也不再害怕了。
Yes. Okay. So now let's take a look. What do we have as an emotion scale? Emotion scale just from very very happy to very very sad.
对啊。
Very very happy to very very sad. So we have annoyed, overjoyed, angry, happy, pleased, and mad.在这个说明那个最高兴的最 happy 的感觉是 overjoyed 是第一个 the happiest
就是前面写的是比较所谓的那个什么很快乐的意思，
没错 overjoyed 所以 overjoyed 是 first then we have as a good happy feelings we have overjoyed happy and pleased as a not very good feelings we have annoyedMad and angry.
对，刚快乐的用法，这里有几个？
三个，
对。
不高兴也是三个。
对啊，不高兴有三个，所以 annoyed、angry 跟 mad 这三个。
所以happy, pleased, and overjoyed are good feelings. Annoyed, angry, and mad are bad feelings.
对，所以等于这三个是不常快乐的情绪。
所以 overjoyed, happy, and pleased 他们是在前面。
快乐。
mad.Angry and annoyed, they are behind. So now we know overjoyed is the happiest of all. So it does the other job. Pleased would be on this second line. Happy would be on the third line. Happy over there. 在 happy 下一个是 mad, just a little bit
生气。
在 mad 的 or angry and mad, 意思就是你自己的感觉。我觉得 mad should be on line number four.Angry should be on line number 5 and annoyed just 烦恼
对就是
可能所以 annoyed would be the last one over there yes so now we know like this it goes like this overjoyed pleased happy mad angry annoyed
就是把最快乐的放在前面所以它是照那个情绪的变化、
yes.
这样子最快乐在前面然后第二个第三个这样啊，生气这样子排过去的意思。
Hey, and let's see what do we have like this. Find your own words and make new sentences. Find your own words and make new sentences. Down at the bottom of the page. And let's take a look. 它告诉我们要做一个 dragon. For D, 它选一个名字叫 dog. And then 这些这样子 the dog was brown.
对了，如果你从第一个字母要选。自己想一个单词，然后造个句子的意思。
可以 ，the dog was brown. So for example, are 如果我们要选动物啊，那我们就说这样子 ，rabbit。
好，如果我们要选动物，那 are 我就选，老师就选 rabbit。
And then we also say the rabbit was very happy, or the rabbit was white, or the rabbit was in the garden， 什么都可以。在 A 如果我们要选动物，一定要选 alligator。Alligator 是什么东西？
鳄鱼。
And then we sell this, the alligator is at the zoo.
鳄鱼在鳄鱼在动物园。
Or we can say the alligator looks very scary.
看起来很可怕。
没错 ，G 如果描写动物一定是 giraffe.
长颈鹿。
Giraffe. And then we sell this, the giraffe has a long neck.
长颈鹿有长的脖子。
Or we can say the giraffe is very tall.
Giraffe 很。
Or we can say like this, the giraffe is the tallest animal on planet Earth. 那是真的。
长颈鹿是最陆地上最长、最大的，
没错，
最高的动物。
And how about this one? O, we can say
octopus
or ox.
ox 牛。
Or ostrich.
鸵鸟。
没错。Okay, if we choose octopus, 那就是我们要说 the octopus lives in the ocean.
好，章鱼住在海里。
可以。And the last one is an. An 那就是有什么动物 an？
I don't know。
如果
没有想到。
等下面一定有啊。
当然有。
H 那个我们的 A B C 的课本那边选 newt。Newt。
哦，像那个壁虎蜥蜴。
对 ，OK， 但是我们可以不一定要选不一定要选好像没有特别。
没有，一定要动物。
突然想不出来。有动物 M very 很明显的，所以我们可以选 nurse or noodles or it doesn't have to be noun. We can choose A B J. For example, we can choose.
对老师说这是选一个字，所以。
对，他没有说一定要选名字。
没有一定要名字。
所以 we could choose new.
New 新的。
As A B J new and also my friend's car is new and expensive.
我朋友这车啊。
Oh, yes. Wow, you have a new jacket, right?
你有新的夹克对吧？
没错。That's it. Or if you choose, really want to choose the noun, we can choose nurse, and they say the nurse works in a hospital and helps sick people. 嗯，那什么意思？
护士在医院工作，帮助生病的。
没错。And now let's take a look 在这里有什么东西。这个 grammar a little difficult for your elementary school students, but we can explain it a little.
对，老师说有点文法有点快，但是你还是可以听哦。
没错。所以这些什么东西 ？The dragon is tired of the presents.
好，这里是用法，就是我们已经讲了，这里是指这个龙很累，所以 is tired， 所以你就用我的，用 I am tired 的这样的用法。然后 of the presents 就是我们上次刚已经解释过了嘛，所以这个就是一样用 got tired of， 就是 get tired of 的用法。所以就变成对这个礼物感到厌倦嘛。
没错，所以我们要说 the dragon is tired of the presents. You just translate the meaning, don't do too much. The dragon is tired of the presents. They were frightened. They were frightened of the bad dragon.
They were just villagers. They were just 人害怕，所以用第一个 frightened 害怕
of the bad dragon.
害怕这一只坏龙。
She is not interested in dancing. 这个很好用的用法 ，anymore， 那就是意思之前她喜欢这个东西，现在不喜欢了。
不再喜欢的意思。
She is not interested in dancing anymore.
她不再对那个跳舞感到兴趣了。
对，这全球现在没有。That was an interesting game. interesting 在这里 ，ing。That was an interesting game.
好，这个是指比赛游戏，所以那是一场，那是一个有趣的比赛或有趣的游戏都是有可能的。
John and his friends were bored at home.
好，这里是指人说选第一个 bored， 所以这两个人就是 John 跟他的朋友呢在家好无聊哦。
Yeah, and let's see, these are the answers, these are the questions regarding the story of the dragon. 速度很快。What were the villagers afraid of?
好，意思指那个村庄的人害怕什么呢？
所以回答就在那边。They were afraid of the bad dragon.
对，他们是怕那个龙的。
That's example. 现在开始从第一个开始。What were the first presents given to the dragon?
好，从故事里面你刚刚有没有印象？那个他们村庄的人给那个龙第一个礼物是什么呢？
你可以去猜测 ，the first presents were mostly food。
大部分他们给他的礼物是食物啊。他说首先呢，一开始他们给他的
记忘记吗？
对，有带给他的是一些食物，所以是减负。
When the dragon was bored, what present did he want?
好，当那个龙感到无聊的时候，无趣的时候，所以呢，他想要的礼物是什么呢？
He wanted the princess.
他想要他们带公主给他，所以答案是公主啦，对不对
？How did the prince feel for the princess?
那王子对这个公主感到怎样？
这个 feel 就是感觉，感到。
对，感觉感到怎样？
所以我们要说，等一下 ，How did the prince feel for the princess? Princess 是女生 ，prince 是男生，回答是从 prince 开始，所以那个 prince 要变 he。
他感觉到抱歉。
这个 prince 就是 prince 在这里 ，he and I feel 要变过去。
过去式。
He felt sorry for her。
对，他为他感到那个抱歉。
her 就是女生她，所以如果你要是多一点开始 ，the prince felt sorry for the princess， 但是简单开始 ，he felt sorry for her。How long did the prince and the dragon fight for？
他们打那个王子跟龙呢，打了多久呢？
在这里可以看到原型的 fight， Genshin 的 fight 就是 fight， 在回答的时候，这个你没学过。
过去式哦。
在回答的时候，你 fight 要不要变 fought？ 所以 they fought for 3 days。
他们打了三天啊。
Who won the fight eventually？
好，我们说这里是最后的，最后他们谁赢了呢？
So that one is the prince. He got killed by the princess dragon. So don't kill me, don't kill me, 我要离开。所以 who won the fight eventually？ The prince won the fight. The prince won the fight. Can you give me the book, please？ 没错 ，the prince won the fight. And that is a story about the brave knight. The brave。刚才这叫 knight， 在故事里面到变成一个 prince， knight 是什么东西？
骑士。
所以 the brave knight，
勇敢的骑士。
Maybe after he saved the princess, the king changed his title from prince into a knight. Maybe. Anyway, that was today's story. Keep reading. It's from the book called Keep Reading. I hope you enjoy the story. Hope you understand the grammar a little bit better. Bye bye.